Well, hello, successful people. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Daniela, your stylish wealth coach. Today, we're going to be talking about the 5 best tax strategies for people who have LLCs. You might have just started your business and you want to make sure that you're playing the game right, or you might have already had an LLC and you want to make sure that you're doing the right things. Wherever you are in your business journey, this is going to be a great video for you to make sure you're taking the right tax strategies to put yourself in a great position. All right, let's go ahead and get into it. All right, the first tax write-off you should be taking as an LLC are startup and organizational costs. Startup and organizational costs count for whenever you need to make some investments in your business before you can actually start operating in business. So whether it is that you need to buy some capital for something, or maybe you need to buy some equipment before you sell it, or maybe you need to learn about the industry more and you take some education courses, whatever it is, it's whatever has to happen before your business is deemed as operational, which means that you are taking clients or you're selling products and you are now starting to run your business. So that is what is called a startup cost. So whatever you take to start that business, you can then expense as a write-off. There is one key rule to remember about this, however. You can take up to $5,000 write-off for that first year in business. What does that mean? So if you have $6,000 of startup costs for your business, you can take a $5,000 write-off for that first year in business, and then that overcharge, so that $1,000 that you ended up spending for your startup costs would be amortized in a period of 180 months. What does amortized mean? It basically means that you're taking the write-off as time goes. All right, the next thing is the home office deduction. This one is so huge because it's actually really great because a lot of us work from home. A lot of us have a home office or a designated place where they do business, or it might be a place where you go and pack your packages for your orders. A lot of us have a place in our homes where we are dedicating that for business in order to do business. Well, this is great because we can actually expense that as a tax write-off, and it's actually a huge tax write-off. So you might be wondering, how would I calculate this? Well, the first rule is that that place has to be a designated place for business purposes in your home. So it can't be like your room slash office, or you know, your kids room slash office, or whatever the case may be. It needs to be your office slash office. So you need to be using that room especially designated for your business in order for it to count off, okay? So after you have decided what room that is designated for your business, then what you're gonna do is measure that room square footage. So you take that total and you're gonna take the home office square footage, you're gonna divide it by the total amount of square footage in your home or your apartment space. And that will give you a percentage. So that's how you know a percentage of your home is being used for office expenses. So now what do you do with that percentage? Well, you're gonna be able to write off every single expense that has to do with your home at that percentage. So for example, if my gas bill is $250 every single month, and I'm using energy for that room, right? I'm going to take off whatever the percentage that was of my home office. So say it was 10%. I'm going to do 10% times $250. So I am writing off $25 per month from my electric bill. So that's just a really simple example. But if you have any enhancements you do for your office, so maybe you got a new couch for your client to sit on, or maybe you got a new desk or whatever it is for that office space, for your office, for your business, just to make that clear, you can go ahead and expense those charges as well. Of course, let me not forget the biggest thing, which is your rent or your mortgage. You can take the percentage of your home office divided by your total amount of square footage of your house, and that percentage multiplied by your mortgage or your rent, and write that off. That is a really big expense. So think about it, if my rent or my mortgage is $2,500 and my percentage was 10%, guess what guys, I'm taking $250 every single month as a tax write-off for my business, because my business is 10% of my home. All right, you guys, before we move on to the next method, if you are enjoying this video, if you're learning from this video, go ahead and give me a big like and comment down below how you're enjoying it, and if you've learned something new, or even which of these strategies you're excited to using for your business. And also, I have a really amazing tool down below in the description box that will really show you how to take proper write-offs and literally reduce your tax bill as much as you can for this year, for any year, according to the tax law. A lot of times our accountants and our CPAs may not know these things because they're looking at the calculations of the accounting and not necessarily the tax law. So this tool will really help you to figure out how you can best save your money on taxes, what you can use in the tax code to really utilize with your LLC to save a lot of money and to set yourself up for success in the future. This tool also has a tracker for expenses and income for your business, as well as how to build business credit and literally just so much more. I'm always adding to this tool just to help you guys with your business finances. So go and check it out down below and I promise you will be pleased. All right, you guys, so our next one is the vehicle deduction. This is whenever you use your car for your business. So the rule is that you have to use your car for 50% or more for business purposes. And after that, you can actually deduct some tax write-offs because you're using your vehicle for your business. One way to take this vehicle deduction is to count your miles. You can use this with QuickBooks or other apps that help you to track your mileage whenever you do it for business purposes. So what you would do is to literally, what the app would do is to count the amount of miles you use, and it's going to multiply it by whatever the rate is for that year. So for 2021, currently it is 56% per mile. So if you're driving, because I drive a lot, you guys, and even my business, I drive a lot. 56 cents per mile adds up a lot over a period of a year, okay? So it's gonna be a lot of tax write-offs you can take just from driving your vehicle for business purposes. Another thing you can do is to depreciate the cost of the vehicle over a time period. So for example, one way to do this is straight line depreciation. So if I bought a car that cost around $50,000, I could depreciate this car over the course of 5 years and take a tax write-off for 1/5 of that car over the next 5 years. So it'd be 10,000, 10,000, 10,000, 10,000, and so on, right? And what that would do is allow me to take a tax write-off every single year until I have gone up to the $50,000 of what I paid for. That is straight line depreciation. There is another method called the double declining method. And what that would mean is that you would take more of those dollars earlier on in the period before you run out. For example, it might be like 35K and then 10K and then 5K and so on. So that's another way you could do it. Remember, there's also code 179 in the tax code that tells us that you can expense the whole cost of your vehicle in one single year, but you must follow these two rules. It has to be over 6,000 pounds and you have to have bought it in your business name. But when you do that, you can literally take, if it was $50,000, you can write off $50,000 of your taxes, which is really amazing. It can really help you for tax time. All right, you guys, the fourth one is marketing and advertising. Obviously, we all know that we need to do some form of marketing and advertising in order to get clients in the door, in order to sell our products out the door, okay? So if it's Facebook ads, if it's, you know, advertising at a college or a pop-up show, whatever it is, any marketing flash that you're doing, paying a customer designer for something, paying just whatever you need to pay in order to get more sales, that is going to be advertising and marketing. And those are things that you can expense at cost, no matter how much it costs you. That is something that you can take a deduction on without having to amortize, because you're doing that year in order to make some sales. It shows that you are in the pursuit of income and you're actively trying to make a profit. So don't be afraid to spend to make money, you guys. It's okay to, you know, put some money in advertising if you think that it's going to make a return. Go ahead and do it and know that it is going to be a tax deduction for you come tax time. Last but not least, and most people don't even know about this, is turning your LLC into an S-Corp, you guys. I know LLCs are really popular and it is an absolutely great way to start your business. However, hopefully there will come a time where the benefits of having an S-Corp will outweigh the benefits of having an LLC, and that's when you need to switch over. So what happens when you turn yourself into an S-Corp? First, you can actually eliminate paying self-employment tax. So self-employment tax is around 15.3%, and as an LLC or sole proprietor, you pay that in order to be an LLC or sole proprietor, right? But when you are an S-Corp, you are actually required to hire yourself as an employee, which means that you can choose however much you get paid and choose however much you pay in taxes from your S-Corp. And this is actually really great because you can actually take a deduction for paying yourself, because whenever you have an employee, it is a required expense that you are taking as a business. So you can actually deduct that amount that you pay yourself as an employee as a tax write-off, which is really huge. And the other bonus to this is that as an LLC, you get to choose however you want to tax yourself. The great thing about that is that if you're an LLC and you tax yourself as an S-Corp, you're able to eliminate that 15.3% self-employment tax and also pay yourself as a shareholder, which will be great because you can take the tax deduction from that as well. So there you have it. Those are the five tax strategies that every LLC needs to be implementing today, and they are going to get you the most write-offs. But like I said during the video, you guys make sure to check out the link down below. It will show you the best ways to reduce your tax bill ridiculously in order for you to have the best tax strategies as an LLC, a sole proprietor, or wherever you are in your business journey. Also, go ahead and consider subscribing to this channel where I teach you guys how to maximize your wealth with little known business and money strategies, all right? With a dash of style, of course. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!